Going to work through a couple of problems to illustrate how we determine log mean temperature difference. So here we have a tubular heat exchanger, and we will consider first a concurrent flow. It is called concurrent or parallel flow when both fluid streams, they stream inside the inside pipe and also in the annular space, are moving in the same direction. On the other hand, we can also have a countercurrent flow. In this case, the stream inside the pipe is moving in one direction while the fluid in the outer annular space moves in the opposite direction. So let's look at an example, and we are given these conditions that a hot fluid enters at 95 degrees C and exits at 35 degrees C. Cold fluid enters the heat exchanger at 5 degrees C and exits at 20 degrees C. Now, in this problem, we are not given as to what type of flow do we have. So we will consider both the parallel flow and counterflow. So if we consider parallel flow, let's first draw a little temperature profile. This is always helpful whenever we are doing these types of problems. So, y-axis we have temperature, and x-axis is the length of the heat exchanger. So, we can identify essentially point 1 and point 2, 1 referring to the one side and 2 to the other side. Now, for the y-axis, if you look at the temperatures, the lowest temperature given is 5 degrees C, and the highest is 95 degrees C. So we can create a scale here, the lowest temperature 5, and the highest 95, and 35 will be somewhere here, and 20 will be about here. Okay, now to draw the profile, we know that the hot fluid enters at 95 in location 1, so this will be the point for 95, and it decreases to 35 on location 2. Whereas the cold fluid, because this is a parallel flow, it enters location 1 at 5 degrees C, shown here, and then a line representing increase of temperature to 20 C in location 2. So now we can write down delta T1, that's the temperature difference for location 1, which is one side of the heat exchanger where both the hot and cold fluid are entering. The delta T1 is 95 minus 5. That equals 90 Celsius. On the other side, we have delta T2 equals 35 minus 20. So delta T2 is 15 degrees Celsius. So from our definition of log mean temperature difference, recall that it is delta T2 minus delta T1 divided by natural log delta T2 over delta T1. Remember in this equation, just for you to check, that delta T2 comes first in the numerator and also in this ratio in the denominator, delta T2 is in the upper part of the ratio. Okay, so log mean temperature difference then for parallel flow is 15 minus 90 divided by natural log 15 over 90. And we can then use our calculator to find out that This calculation is 41.86 degrees Celsius. So the log mean temperature difference is 41.86 degrees C. Now remember, this number, since this is the average, must be between 15 and 90. It cannot be less than 15 or it cannot be more than 90. Remember, this is a log mean between two numbers, 15 and 90. So it must be between those two numbers. Okay, now we can go ahead and determine what's the log mean temperature difference for counterflow. Again, we draw the axis, y-axis for temperature, x-axis for the locations, 1 and 2. So we have again 5, 20, 35, 95. So again, the hot fluid enters the counterflow heat exchanger as 95 to 35. Now remember, this is counterflow, so the cold fluid is entering at location 2, 5 degrees C, and it increases to 20 degrees C. So now we have delta T1, temperature difference on location 1, is 95 minus 20. And delta T2 is 35 minus 5. So delta T1 then equals 75. And delta T2 equals 30 degrees C. So the log mean temperature difference equals delta T2, which is 30, minus delta T1, that is 75, divided by natural log of delta T2, that is 30, divided by delta T1, that's 75. Again, using our calculator, we calculate this ratio to be equal to 49.11 degrees C. Now, if we look at these two numbers that we just calculated, note that for counterflow heat exchanger, the log mean temperature difference is higher than the what we got for the parallel flow. Now, you will find that for the same conditions as we had in this problem, you will always get a higher log mean temperature difference for counterflow. That is why the counterflow heat exchanger is always more energy efficient. The delta T is always more in counterflow compared to parallel flow for the same conditions for temperatures at the entrance and exit. Now let's do one more problem. And in this case, we have a hot fluid entering at 95 degrees C, exiting at 50 degrees C, whereas cold fluid enters at 15 degrees C and exits at 65 degrees C. Just as we drew the y and x axis before, let's first draw these axes for parallel flow. And we have the temperatures on y axis, which the lowest temperature is 15. The highest temperature is 95, and so we have 50 and location 1 and 2. So now again, we draw the temperature profiles. So for the hot fluid, starting at 95, the temperature drops to 50 degrees C on location 2. Remember, this is parallel flow. and exiting at 65 degrees C. Well, now we have a problem. And the problem is that we cannot have the cold fluid going exiting at a higher temperature than the exit temperature for the hot fluid. This is thermodynamically not possible. So anytime when you draw these profiles, and if they cross, that means this arrangement is just not possible. So in other words, the heat exchanger cannot operate as parallel flow for these conditions. Let's see if we can operate this heat exchanger in the counterflow mode. So again, we will draw the profiles. Again, we have temperature for hot fluid dropping from 95 to 50. And for the cold fluid, it is increasing from 15. And remember, this is counterflow. The cold fluid is entering at location 2. And this goes up to 65. Now, this is possible. This arrangement is possible because these curves did not cross. So now delta T1 on side 1 is 95 minus 65, or 30 degrees C, and delta T2 is 50 minus 15, and that equals 35 degrees C. So the log mean temperature difference is then delta T2 minus delta T1 over natural log of delta T2 over delta T1. And delta T2 is 35 minus delta T1 is 30 divided by natural log of 35 over 30. And the answer that you will get is 32.44 degrees C. So again, to summarize, when you draw these temperature profiles, and this is always good to do that, we find that for these conditions that were given to us in the second problem, we just cannot operate this heat exchanger in the parallel flow mode because we cannot have the cold fluid leaving at a temperature higher than the exit temperature of the hot fluid. That's thermodynamically not possible. Whereas we can operate it under counterflow conditions, and as we have just calculated, the log mean temperature difference then is 32.44 degrees C.